The contemporary human life revolves in a circle. Like, react, comment, share, subscribe. This routine always chases you. In average, a person spends 2 hours 22 minutes on social media on a daily basis. The majority of time, comparing the life of oneself with the highlight of others, leading to a major mental distress.
पहिला चाहिँ हामीले बच्चाहरुलाई हुन्छ नि आफ्नो स्कुलको बच्चाहरुसँग मात्र कम्पेयर गर्थ्यो हु इज द बेस्ट सिंगर हु इज द वेयरिङ द बेस्ट क्लोथ्स अनि त्यो एउटा हदसम्म लिमिट हुन्थ्यो क्या तर नाउ द्याट वी ह्याभ एक्सेस टु अनलिमिटेड इन्फर्मेसन वी क्यान चेक अन पिपल वी क्यान चेक अन स्ट्रेन्जर्स फ्रम अल ओभर द वर्ल्ड
यु आर अन सोसियल मिडिया स्टम्बल इन्टु अ पर्सन यु वेव हिम हाई एन्ड ही स्टार्ट टकिङ Slowly, the habit becomes contagious. Dopamine is released in mind after positive social stimuli. It is the same chemical that gets released after we smoke, drink, and gamble. Highly addictive. So in pursuit of greatness, humans created a drug that is perfectly legal. The social media has set high standards for the definition of beauty, luxury, and the needs of life.
And what they see is, I don't have a I'm not beautiful, or maybe I'm not competent, you know. So they slowly start, so it becomes systemic depression. People start thinking that I lack certain characteristics. I do not have that beauty which is portrayed in social media.
Through social media, you expect from strangers. And when the expectations are high, one hits a low point. One day, your best friend on the screen loses his virtual existence and you face the loneliness that never should exist. Statistically, people who use Facebook and Instagram are more depressed than other people. Social media has embedded itself so deep within humans that once you hold it, it stains in your skin. One keeps searching for the virtual togetherness that one shall never find. Mental trauma chimes in because what you see on the screen may not be the reality that exists. We are all a part of this big social media circle. This is Nisali Sasi reporting for KUTV.